Héctor Campos, the writer-director of the film, and Jasper, who is going to be translating for us. I'm particularly pleased that this is the closing film for this for Brave Talk screenings, because it does end on a such a positive note in a way, even though it deals with such pain. But let's get on with the Q&A. I'm going to be asking questions for a little while, and then I will pass it over to you to ask some questions. We have a mic there, and it would be great if you could come down and to the mic here when the time comes, because we are recording this and it makes it much better for us. If you really don't want to do that, then we'll take your questions from the seat, but it is much nicer if you come down. Anyway, to begin, how did the idea for this film come about? What was the inspiration for you?
Bueno, todo comenzó por una amiga que es antropóloga, fotógrafa, antropóloga forense, que me contó que en una exhumación pasó algo similar a lo del inicio de la película, ¿no?
Everything started with a friend of mine, a photographer and anthropologist, forensic anthropologist, photographer, who told me about an excavation she had done.
¿No? Que encontraron un cuerpo que no estaba planificado, que iban a encontrar, y que dentro de ese cuerpo había, era el cuerpo de un varón, los restos, mejor dicho, los huesos de un varón, y dentro había la foto de una chica. Entonces yo sentí que eso era como que el motor o el corazón para empezar a desarrollar esta película.
They found a body which they didn't have expected to find in that excavation, and in that body they found the photo of a girl. And that was like the motor, like the heart of the story and how it got started.
Sí, yo había trabajado años antes en un documental que tenía que ver con el tema de exhumaciones, de la violencia política que se vivió en el Perú. Pero este hecho, esta anécdota de mi amiga la fotógrafa, sentía que me servía para hablar de esos años, pero desde el presente, desde la hora.
So I, years ago, I had worked on a documentary on about excavations and about political persecutions and people killed for political reasons. But this time, this was the story that my friend told me was really what made me do something about this issue, but then put in the present, today's story.
Así que después de conversar con esta amiga, fui a mi casa y escribí como que la primera argumento de lo que fue al final la película, ¿no?
So right after talking to this friend of mine, I went home and I started writing on like the argument, like the initial idea of what I made, and what the film I made in the end.
Porque esta fotografía a punto encontrada, casi a punto de desaparecer, me parecía una buena metáfora para hablar de la...
Because this found photograph that was almost disappearing, that seemed to me to be a really good metaphor for what I was wanting to tell.
And it's, as you say, it's a film very much about the present, mm-hmm. but a present in which the past has to be dealt with. Mm-hmm. We have to decide what mm-hmm. to do with the past. And it really concentrates on two characters, Fidel and Graciela. I think it's very interesting that you make Fidel mm-hmm. struggling with it as well. Could you talk a bit about how you approached his character?
Interesante. Sí, el personaje de Fidel se fue construyendo poco a poco. Para mí, el conflicto del personaje era el siguiente.
The character of Fidel was being built up little by little, and for me, the conflict within the character was this.
No, era qué hacer ante esta situación. Cumplir con la ética y entregar el cuerpo a los organismos del Estado que había que entregarle, o tener un acto humanitario y mentirle a la señora para que ella pueda dejar su búsqueda y creer que ha encontrado a su marido.
That was for me the interesting was what to do. Well, either follow the regular norms and ethics to deliver the body and to the authorities where it's supposed to be, or lie to the woman, telling it was actually her husband, disappeared husband, and so she can leave the searching behind her.
Y para hacer más compleja estas preguntas del personaje era decidí tejer como un personaje que tiene muchos años trabajando en eso y que a veces sin él ser muy consciente también sufre las secuelas de un trabajo de este tipo.
And to make this issue more complex, I decided to have a character that has many years working in this field, and who also has a lot of, and as a consequence from that, has a lot of trouble with himself in it.
Que no se puede generalizar, pero muchos de los antropólogos forenses con los que a los que conocía y a los que entrevisté para hacer el guion tenían en cierta, en más o menos este tipo de no sé si de traumas, este tipo de complicaciones en la persona, en el carácter, ¿no?
One cannot generalize, but I interviewed lots of anthropologists and people working in that field, and many of them, they have, well, I wouldn't call it a trauma, but they have like problems with it, issues with it.
Porque hay que tener en cuenta, y también me lo decían ellos, es que no es simplemente encontrar gente muerta, sino que es gente que ha sido asesinada y desaparecida, ¿no?
So what you have to think about, it's not only a matter of finding dead people, but it's finding dead people that were killed, that were murdered.
¿No? Y no solamente es la carga de estas personas que tienen que encontrarle una identidad, sino también, no sé si sufren, o sea, es decir, tienen la presión de los familiares que quieren encontrar a sus personas, a sus seres queridos desaparecidos.
So, and then it's not only the side of finding these people that were killed and finding out about what happened to them, but they also have to deal with the pressure of the families who want their loved ones to be found.
Entonces, a raíz de esas cosas empecé a construir la personalidad de Fidel.
Starting from these things, I went on working and constructing, building up the character that made Fidel.
No, alguien que no puede dormir, no, que tiene problemas a veces hasta para saborear las comidas, bueno, muchas otras.
Somebody that cannot sleep and has trouble sometimes actually taste foods, these that kind of things.
And he's somebody who is internalizing a lot of his problems, it seems to me. And this film is also reflecting that by using such a restrained style. It's a very, it's not a sensationalist film. All the colors are very muted. It's a quiet film in many ways. Was that always part of your concern to have the tone of the film reflect his sense of, I suppose, isolation almost?
Está hablando del estilo, ¿no?
Del estilo, lo contenido.
Sí. Eso no fue algo que lo pensé desde un inicio. Para hacer la primera versión de guión, era una versión mucho más coloquial, había muchos más momentos de relax en la película, pero cada vez que iba haciendo una nueva corrección y una nueva corrección, la película se iba poniendo más oscura, más apagada, ¿no? Era como que solo sentía que se iba más noche, o sea, casi sentía como que no había momentos de sol, cada vez iba volviendo más oscura.
It wasn't my initial idea. In the very first version, the very first draft of the script, I had more moments that were relaxing and more open moments and more extravagant moments maybe. But every new draft, every new version of the script, it started becoming darker and more restrained and more inside.
Sí, y ahí sí, no eran canciones, como no eran canciones tan conscientes, ¿no? Dejé que se fuera yendo, tomara ese camino, ¿no?
I wasn't that conscious about it, that it was actually going and taking that direction.
Pero y sí quería un momento en el que hubiera mucho sol, mucha luz en todo sentido, que era el momento de la sierra, ¿no? Cuando se van a la sierra, pero me gustaba también esa dualidad, que donde hubiera más luz, habrían también muchos más cuerpos encontrados, ¿no?
There was a moment that there was a lot of light, and that, like when they're going to the mountain range, and there was actually a moment when there was all that light, that was the moment when the bodies, all those bodies were found.
I think it's very important to me anyway, I think that you don't make specific or explicit in the film who died, who killed, why they were killed. You could have gone that way. I'm glad you didn't. But could you explain why you didn't say, oh, these were killed by the government authorities, the military, or these were killed by the rebels. Could you explain why you kept it a little ambiguous?
¿Quién lo mató?
¿Contaste quién mató a quién?
Sí, es que lo que me interesaba hablar en la película no es quiénes o por qué lo mataron, ¿no? O quiénes fueron, o fueron los terroristas, o fueron agentes del Estado. De eso no me interesaba hablar en la película. Intentaba hablar de, del sufrimiento de estas personas que están buscando a sus familiares, ¿no? O sea, centrarme más en lo humano que si quieren llamarlo en lo político. Eso me interesaba más, ¿no? En,
I wasn't interested in finding out or saying who killed who and who was guilty and who blamed. I was more interested in the human aspect and the suffering of the people, of the persons, the people left behind, you know, and how they feel and how they deal with it.
Que tienen buscando a sus familiares 20, 25 años, un poco más, y también es de los de estas personas que trabajan haciendo, tratando de encontrarles identidad y que también se van cargando de toda esta.
So that's about the people that have spent like 20, 25 years trying to find their loved ones, but also the people working in that field and what it does to them.
Mm-hmm. And do you feel it's a film that is very specific to Peru, or do you feel that it has, because to me, it, one of the strengths of the film is that it speaks more widely than just dealing with Peruvian history. It's more general, it's more universal.
Parece que es muy, ¿te parece que es muy particular a Perú o es más universal que a mí me parece que es más?
Sí, claro, yeah, claro, sí, understand. Eso también me servía, claro, para porque este esto que pasó en Perú en los años 80 es algo que ha pasado, que está pasando también un poco en Colombia, bueno, lo de México, imagino que muchos deben saber. Entonces, porque claro, no importa, es que no importe, mejor dicho, o sea, sí importa saber quiénes y por qué lo mataron, pero también está esta cuestión humanitaria. Yo creo que eso le da universalidad a la película, o por lo menos eso intentaba, ¿no? Y eso fue lo que busqué también cuando ya iba creando el guión. O sea, eso fue una cuestión consciente de que escribí el guión, no fue una decisión.
Yeah, it was, of course, it's what happened in the 1980s in Peru is just what happened and what's happening in Colombia and right now also in Mexico. It's happening, of course. Well, it's not that it's not important. It is very important, but I wanted also to show the other side, like how, what it does to people now and today. And that is, yeah, that's actually how people deal with issues like this. And that's actually, yeah, that's quite universal, actually.
And has the film been seen in Peru yet?
No, ha sido solamente presentada en un festival de cine en Lima, pero todavía no en salas comerciales. Que el plan, la estrategia es estrenarlo a mediados de año, ¿no? En los siguientes meses.
Well, it has shown, it was screened in a festival, in a film festival in Lima, but it hasn't been shown in the commercial cinema movie theaters yet. And the plan is to show it, to screen it in a few months, like halfway this year, more or less.
And how was it received by the people when they saw it in Lima? Did it, was there any mixed reaction or?
Sí, fueron reacciones diversas, ¿no? Una que a mí me sorprendió, no sé si sorprendió, sí, creo que es la palabra, no sé si tanto decepcionó, es que un amigo me contó que algunas personas que salieron, espero que no hayan sido muchas que se hayan hecho esa pregunta, no sabían de dónde eran esos muertos, o sea, no sabían de dónde eran esos muertos de la película.
Yeah, the reactions were very diverse, very different from each other, and what surprised me or maybe disappointed me or something was that a friend of mine told me that some people left the movie theater and they didn't know where those bodies were from. They didn't understand where those bodies came up from.
Y eso pasa porque, y eso es intencional, hay mucha gente que no quiere que se hablen de estos temas, que no quiere que se que diga, okay, eso ya pasó, y por qué recordarlo, hay que seguir para adelante y no mirar atrás, que de por sí me parece una actitud un poco egoísta, ¿no? Y hasta marginadora.
And that happens because the cause of that is that a lot of people, they don't want this to come out, they don't want to remember, they want to let it go, and it's a bit, they don't want to know about it anymore, they want to maybe move on with their lives. And it's a bit of a, yeah, a selfish, egoist mentality.
Because if there is going to be any moving forward, moving on, you have to deal with the past to be able to move on, really. You have to say, this is what the past was, now let's move. As long as you hide it, you can't really move forward.
Para poder seguir adelante hay que saber lo que pasó.
Sí, claro. O sea, es bueno lo que tú has dicho. O sea, hay que conocer el pasado para que las mismas cosas no se vuelvan a repetir, ¿no? Sí, pero y claro, sí, es algo más creo que es algo para hablar con mayor amplitud, pero es como que, o sea, así sean, en el Perú hay aproximadamente 15,000 desaparecidos, según las cifras.
Well, yeah, of course, that is something that that's what you're saying is to move forward, to be able to move on, you have to know what happens in the past. And that is a bit, you could talk about it in a more wide perspective, but in Peru, there are about 15,000 people missing, disappeared.
No, entonces implica de que hay 15,000 personas, o 15,000, un poco menos, buscando a sus familiares. Entonces, no digo que al hablar esas cosas es como que para flagelarse o torturarse, sino simplemente ver al otro, que es algo que a veces no pasa, ¿no?
Yeah, so it's 15,000 people that have their families and loved ones looking for them, and it's not necessary to hurt yourself or to torture yourself about those people, but at least see and understand, see what happened.
No, porque entonces, o sea, lo que está pasando con esos familiares es que son doblemente olvidados, es decir, doblemente desaparecidos. Lo desaparecieron y la gente que busca a sus familiares tampoco quieren ver eso, entonces, o sea, no digo que la carga, pero lo que viven esas personas es, o sea, no, como que no, como que no, o sea, sienten que no son vistos, no sé si, ¿no? O sea, son doblemente invisibles.
It's a bit like the people that disappeared and the trying to look for them, it's a bit like they're twice, disappeared twice, they're double, their disappearances are doubled. Like people don't want to deal with them and they're not being seen.
Y aquí quiero poner un poco de contexto para que se entienda un poco más, es que a diferencia de Chile o Argentina, que también pasaron por procesos similares, en Perú muchas de las personas desaparecidas o asesinadas eran gente muy pobre, muy humilde, de las zonas de la sierra del Perú, de otros lugares. Y eso los hace sin menos derechos.
And I want to try to put it a bit more into context, like to compare it with Argentina and Chile, where similar disappearances, where lots of people disappeared, well, similar things happened. Only in Peru, the difference was that most people that disappeared, they were from very, very poor social classes. They were very, and with very little rights.
Claro. Gente que en muchos casos, no se vale generalizar, pero muchos, era quechua hablante, o sea, que hablaban quechua, una lengua que no es el castellano, ¿no?
I don't want to generalize, but in many cases there were people that spoke Quechua. They didn't speak Spanish. They spoke an indigenous language.
Y entonces eso los hace, si de por sí era, son pobres y a veces muchas veces marginados, esto es una doble marginación.
So you could say in the way that because they were poor, they were the marginalized people in the margins. That you could say that was like a double, and being disappeared was like a double marginalization, double.
So, I mean, the film is really about making people aware of this, in a way. I think we now should perhaps invite some questions from the audience. As I say, if you do have one, if you could come down to the mic over here, down at the bottom of the steps here, it would be great, because then we can hear you. Please, anybody out there? Questions? You surely must have some questions.
Lo quiero hacer en español, porque...
I'll translate into English.
En primer lugar, felicidades por la película. Me parece una muy buena película, muy interesante. Mi pregunta es que la película tiene mucho política por mi parte, porque yo veo que por el cambio de gobierno, cambio la forma de investigar. Y la película sugiere que la justicia no está muy cooperativa. ¿Usted puede comentar eso?
I see the film to be very political, like from the change of the government and a new government, and the Justice Department seems not to be very cooperative. They don't really want to help. Could you comment on that?
Sí, Claro, lo que pasa es que las exhumaciones, y yo no soy especialista en tanto en el tema, no sé si será en otros países, pero por lo menos en Perú tienen dos connotaciones, ¿no? Una humanitaria y otra judicial, ¿no? Entonces, es decir, cuando hacen una exhumación es para entregarle los restos a una persona, si tiene identidad, y después ver las causas de por qué esa persona fue asesinada.
Yeah, I want to talk about the excavations, the digging up the graves, have basically two aims, two goals, and the one's the human, two aspects. There's a human aspect, and there's the judicial, the legal aspect. So there's a human aspect of giving back the remainders to their next to their loved ones, their families, and then there's the judicial, the legal aspect to find out who did it, what happened.
Entonces, si en el caso de la película, por tomar el ejemplo, esa persona que han encontrado tiene un impacto de bala en esta zona del cráneo y que ha sido un impacto muy cerca, esa persona no murió en un enfrentamiento, esa persona murió ejecutada.
So, in case of this one, the impact of the person that died with the bullet in the back of the head, which was done from very close range, like basically touching the head, that person did not die in battle, that did not die in a war encounter. It was that person was executed.
No, entonces, si después en la investigación se ve que fue por parte del ejército, en esos años hubo un encargado del ejército y se puede abrir un proceso judicial al que en esos años fue encargado de la base militar o policial en esa zona de donde encontraron ese desaparecido.
So knowing that it was done by the military, then the military have somebody in charge, so then they can open up a process, start a process, and find out against the person who was in charge of that in that time of that area.
Y ahí es donde comienzan las trabas para que no hayan esos cargos judiciales. A veces ya no hay muchas exhumaciones para evitar esa carga, ese juicio a ese militar o policía.
So that's where the obstacles are. The people don't want that to happen. They don't. So to avoid having these court cases against a military official, there's not many excavations happening.
No. Entonces, un poco lo que sé que se está tratando de plantear ahora es que solamente haya unas exhumaciones humanitarias que ya solamente se centren en encontrar restos y entregar a sus familiares y olvidarse de lo judicial.
So that's basically what at the moment why there's mainly humanitary excavation, so they simply want to find the remains and leave them with the families and then leave it at that.
We've got about 2 minutes left if anybody else has got a question. If not, I'm just going to ask you one thing then before we go. Have you had any pressure put on you not to make this film or to change the film in any way?
¿Hubo alguna presión por cualquier manera para no hacer la película o cambiar el tema?
No, para nada. No, ni en el momento de escribirla, ni en el momento de... Ganamos un fondo del Estado peruano. ¿Soy yo? No creo.
¿Es mí?
No hemos tenido ningún problema. Seguro cuando la estrenemos van a haber comentarios, ¿no? Un poco en contra de hablar de eso, pero bueno, es inevitable. Y espero que se hable, o sea, lo que no quisiera es que, al margen de que guste o no guste, pero que se toque ese tema, ¿no? Para mí sería lo mejor.
So no, not at all, actually, from the beginning, and while writing it, there was no pressure whatsoever, and we even got some funding, some money from the state, from national state, so probably when it's being screened, when it's being shown, then I guess there will be people asserting in against it and about it, but that's, I hope people actually then will talk about it and discuss it, and that the issue will be talked about.
This discussion is good, which is what Brave Talks has been about. This was the last of the four talks for this year. I'd like to thank you all for coming. I'd like to thank actually the team that have been supporting these conversations. I've felt very comfortable for the four of them, so personal thanks there. But mainly, could you please thank Héctor Gálvez Campos and Jasper for translating. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thanks.